Welcome back to Hong Kong.
On the morning of Sunday, April 11th, we approach the harbor of Hong Kong. A British crown colony until 1997, more than 5 million people are sandwiched into an area where commerce is the prime order of the day. The economic pace of the colony is almost feverish. The cityscape seen from the ship is striking. And that Shelby's husband was at the terminal to greet her. Captain Chang skillfully parked our ship at the famous Ocean Terminal building.
Where is it next?
Yeah, sure. Please keep in touch.
I'll be seeing you.
Thank you very much.
Well, why did you leave?
I'm just like, oh, please.
Dad,
those are
your parents.
Mom!
Oh, that's so
Once off the ship, we made our way through the Ocean Terminal shopping complex. Out on Kowloon streets, many of us loaded onto buses for the Hong Kong city orientation. We were docked on the Kowloon Peninsula, just a short walk away from the hustling shopping streets of Kowloon. Nathan Road is the main street, the Golden Mile, so called because of the huge amount of money spent on Hong Kong electronics and other wares. But beyond the streets, brandishing Sonys and Panasonics, are the old market streets of Kowloon. This is Temple Street, the liveliest fruit, vegetable, and poultry market in Kowloon. Many of us took rides on the Star Ferry to Hong Kong Island. It costs less than a dime and it's only a 7-minute ride. The best bargain in Hong Kong. On the Hong Kong orientation practicum, we learned more about this powerful financial center of East Asia. On the island of Hong Kong is Victoria Peak. The Peak Tramway takes you to the top for the classic panoramic views of the colony.
Where's Hong Kong?
Where's Hong Kong? Hong Kong disappeared. I could see the governor's house just a few minutes ago, but now it's gone.
Yeah, of Hong Kong.
What are you doing here?
Did you hold this?
Here we go.
Oh yeah, this is what it's supposed to look like.
Down.
Down? Okay.
There you go.
That's the view.
We are in the evening.
Okay, now pull it away.
Let's do it. Yeah.
Okay, time's up.
We went to lunch in Aberdeen, located on the south coast of Hong Kong Island. Aberdeen is a floating village that bobs and sloshes on its harbor. More than 2,000 seafaring boats and families make up this floating community. A few of us grabbed a sampan for a tour through Aberdeen's liquid streets. At the foot of Victoria Peak is the city of Hong Kong itself. These wafer-thin streetcars were fun to ride and a great way to get around the city. many of us inspected the wares of Stanley Market on the other side of Hong Kong Island.
Brothers. It's presents.
It was an early morning call for many going to Beijing. More than 200 of us went to Beijing, participating in many standard and faculty-directed practica.
Where are you going, John?
I'm going to the wall. And I may hit the wall.
Smart.
Hi, I'm Mom and Dad. I'm on my way to Beijing.
Beijing is a city with a history dating back thousands of years. We came here to see the important historical and political sites, meet the people, and learn more about one of the world's ancient civilizations. Most of us visited the Temple of Heaven. In Tiananmen Square, the scene of the 1989 democracy demonstrations and ensuing massacre. In the background, a huge poster of Mao presides over the square. This is the Gate of Heavenly Peace. Almost all of us in Beijing went to study the Forbidden City. This huge complex of royal halls and pavilions was off limits for 500 years to common Chinese. This was home to two dynasties of emperors, the Ming and the Qing. None of us who were in Beijing missed the opportunity to visit the Great Wall. Extending over 5,000 miles from China's east coast to the Gobi Desert, these walls were constructed in an effort to keep out marauding nomads. The wall was never very effective as a defense line, but it was successful as a kind of elevated highway, transporting people and equipment across mountainous terrain. Walking a distance away from the main gate, you could find that solitude and quiet you needed to really appreciate this impressive symbol of ancient Chinese architecture and tyranny. And on the road to the Ming tombs were these stone animals and warlords, guardians for the deceased Ming emperors. And back in Beijing, many of us visited some of the city's important colleges and universities to meet students and get in some good dancing. In Beijing, we could also attend an acrobatic show. And the zoo, which featured a couple of huge panda bears. On Thursday, April 15th, we all had to rendezvous back in Hong Kong.
I want a job. Help me get a job.
Professor Schweitzer led a group on an FDP to the Hong Kong Coca-Cola bottling plant to learn more about the huge business of making soft drinks. As the city lights came on, it was time to reboard the ship. Our next port of call was Keelung, Taiwan.
We're not late though. We're not late.
It's on.
Goodbye.
We are set to sail immediately. All passengers should be on board. The gate will be pulled immediately. All passengers should now be on board. Thank you. Good night. Merrick Weisman, ID 480. All passport IDs should be here. Where's the captain number?